This is a quick tips and tricks video on how to create an internal or thin wall boundary condition within a Fluent CFD simulation. I already created a quick video showing the topology that was needed within Space Claim to get access to applying a thin wall or internal wall boundary condition. So this is the example we used. You'll notice that if I highlight this solid, you can see the holes. This was the baffle plate in a duct example that I used, and you'll remember that the key features within Space Claim is that we need two volumes that are touching, and we need to use the merge topology setting so that we ensure a one-to-one node connection in the mesh. So I already have my mesh created, and I've gone ahead and created a couple name selections for our boundary conditions, just the inlet and outlet, and we'll see how this comes into Fluent. So I've already got it open, and we've got our mesh here, and we can take a quick look and at the mesh. And I'll turn off the inlet and outlet, they get colored different color, and you'll notice I've got my gray outer walls, and then I've got this green internal boundary condition, which is labeled here. And if I turn that off and hit display, you'll see that disappears, and that's an internal boundary condition that will allow fluid to pass directly through it. And again, I'll hit display and I'll turn on the edges, and you'll notice that's one single boundary condition. So even though we've got these circles where we want holes for fluid to pass through, and then outside of that we would want to apply a wall, they've actually got bundled into the same boundary condition, so we can't actually use this as is. So what we have to do is go back into our mesher, and we actually have to create a new name selection for the wall itself. Okay, so we'll just hide one of the bodies, and this gives us access to that surface, and we simply select the surface, which is going to be our wall boundary condition, and we create a new name selection, and in this case I'll call it baffle plate. Okay, and that creates my new name selection here, and we can see that. And when I go back into Fluent, I've got a second instance here open. You'll notice that now I've got in this list feature tree, I've got a baffle plate and the holes for the internal boundary conditions. So if I go to display mesh and I turn off the baffle plate, now I can just see my holes, which is what I want as an internal or interior boundary condition. And if I turn on the baffle plate and turn off the holes, we've got a separate internal boundary condition there. So that leads us, that's separated out the boundary conditions. They're still both internal. Now it's a real simple case of selecting the baffle plate, changing the boundary condition type from this pull down menu to a wall. And you'll notice that it generates a wall boundary condition, and that's listed here. So now when I go in and hit display mesh, I'll select the baffle plate. Now it's changed color to gray, and it's a wall. You'll also notice that it puts a shadow boundary condition in here. Basically, that's the opposite side of the wall. So we've got baffle plate one side and baffle plate shadow the other side here. But basically, it's one single boundary condition that's connected. Okay, so another quick tip here, we named that baffle plate. You'll notice that we named these inlet and outlet, and they automatically got applied as an inlet and outlet in Fluent. We can do the same thing with the baffle plate if we use the wall string. So if I delete this, reselect that surface, and instead of calling it baffle plate, I call it baffle wall. Fluent will detect that wall string, and when I bring it in, it automatically gets applied as a wall boundary condition. You can see that here in this feature tree, and again you can see in the graphic window the gray wall boundary condition is highlighted, and I've still got my green holes, which are interior boundary conditions which allow fluid to pass directly through them. Now the reason we have those boundary conditions is actually because we have two separate volumes and they're connected. So you'll see here in the cell zones we've got our two volumes for either side, and that comes from the mesher. We can actually get rid of that by grouping those together. So if we come back into our mesher and we just show all bodies, and we select both of these volumes, and we create a new name selection, and we'll call this fluid volume. And now we've got both volumes in one single name selection. When that comes into Fluent now, and we'll see this here, we now have one single cell zone, which is called fluid volume, and because of that, it no longer has the explicit boundary condition of internal. The holes are there, but the internal boundary condition disappears, and this just comes in as one single cell zone that's connected through those holes. That's quite important, because if we'd have done that in the very first step, if we'd have grouped those two volumes together and we hadn't named our file name selection, we'd have just got one single duct, all that detail would have just been completely lost and wouldn't have come in at all. But anyway, that's the basic process to set up an internal wall. We have to create a name selection on the wall and bring it in. If we use the string WALL wall within the name selection, Fluent will automatically apply a wall boundary condition there. If we don't do that, it'll come in as an interior, and we can simply change the type from interior to wall boundary condition, and we have our baffle plate.